Hola a todos, ¿cómo están el día de hoy? Espero que se encuentren muy bien. Yo siempre muy feliz y muy agradecida de poder estar con ustedes. Today we're gonna work on ser y estar. Are you ready? Let's see. Actually, ser y estar, what is to be in English, okay, is a really important topic. Because even if you just start to study Spanish, or you know, we start to see ser y estar kind of like a beginner's level, you're gonna learn ser y estar different parts of ser y estar through the whole process of learning Spanish. Therefore, we're gonna divide this video in two parts. The first part, we're just gonna talk about the general characteristics of ser y estar, okay, for the basic. But the second part, we're gonna kind of try to talk about these ambiguities related with ser y estar. Sometimes you say, yeah, I know the rule, but in this case, I don't know, it doesn't apply. Okay, so we're gonna try to talk about that. So, to start, ser y estar is like in English, to be, okay? But in Spanish, we divide this verb, then in English is to be, okay, in two verbs. One is ser, and one is a star. And you're gonna use these two verbs, okay, and according to the different situations and contexts, okay? So we're gonna start first with ser. Ser we're gonna use when we want to express, okay, characteristic, quality, permanent characteristic, permanent quality of things and people, okay? For example, la casa es grande. La casa es bonita. El carro o el coche es fantástico, es muy rápido. Okay, I'm describing, okay, the permanent characteristic, the permanent quality of something. Okay, in this case, an object. But why about people? For example, if I want to describe myself, if I want to say permanent characteristic about myself, about a person, okay, for example, soy mediana. Yeah, well, I'm not super tall, I'm not really sure. Medium, yeah. Soy mediana, soy morena, brunette, okay? Soy seria, you think so? Soy divertida, you think so? Soy aburrida, you think so? Okay, I just saying like basically, you think I'm boring, you think I'm serious, you think I'm funny, okay? So this is, I describing my personality, I describing the way I look, okay? So, or soy mujer, for example, I'm describing my gender, okay? So, in these cases, we're gonna use ser, remember, to describe permanent quality or permanent characteristic of people or things. The second part, we're gonna use for We're gonna use for nationality, origin, or name, okay? So, for example, soy María. In that case, if I want to say my name, I know I can say me llamo María, but you can say soy María, okay? I'm María. Soy peruana. I say my nationality with ser, okay? I'm Peruvian. Soy peruana o soy de Perú, okay? Soy María, soy de Perú, soy, well, in the case of origin, for example, I don't live at the moment in my country. I live at the moment in London. I live in East London, for example. So if I around here, people, when they ask me, so where are you from? Which part of London are you from? I say, soy de East London, okay? I'm from East London. So again, nacionalidad, origen, and your name. It's another way for you to say your name with verbo ser, okay? So remember that. The other part, you can say, use verbo ser for professions, oficios, what is like, what is your work, okay? Not necessarily if you have a profession, but for your work. And for date, okay? For date, fechas. So, for example, soy profesora, okay? Soy profesora de español. But what in the case that I was, for example, working as a builder? What is a builder? Albañil. Could say, él es albañil, o ella es albañil, o soy albañil, okay? So, it's not a profession, but it's like my job, okay? So, for your jobs, for your occupation, for your profession, you use verbo ser. Another one, you're gonna use for date. So, how you ask people, like, about time? Like, for example, if I want to ask you, what is the time? What time is it? Okay? ¿Qué hora es? And how you reply? Es la una, son las dos, son las tres, son las cuatro. Okay? So in this case, it's no time for confusion. It's always gonna be ser. Remember, profession, occupation, and date, ser. Okay, so this is the first part, the first very general part of verbo ser. Let's move to estar. Now, with estar, what happened with estar? And the first part of estar, okay, you have to always, oh my God, when I teach, especially when I teach in schools, I always say to my students, you think estar, location, you think estar, but location, 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 location. Ubicación. I don't try to be sound crazy, but estar, location. It has another uses, of course, but the first thing that you need to understand about verbo estar, what also still to be, but to be in another form in Spanish, and we're gonna use for location. So remember, always gonna be with basically a question like, ¿dónde está? Está en. Okay, ¿dónde está la farmacia? La farmacia está en el norte, está en el sur, está a la derecha, está a la izquierda. Okay, so estar is with location. Location about, like for example, of the pharmacy, like the example that I gave. O for example, like, ¿dónde está, no sé, España? ¿Dónde está Argentina? ¿Dónde está Perú? Okay, so location in general is always gonna be verbo estar. Now, another part that is actually very important for verbo estar is mood. Like, how you feel? Yeah, mood. How you feel. Okay, for example, estoy cansada, estoy aburrida, estoy triste. Okay, so to express your mood, okay, your current mood, you're gonna use verbo estar. So then is when sometimes it's like kind of ambiguity, then I will explain later on. It's like people tell me, but so I cannot say soy aburrida. I cannot say soy feliz. I cannot say, you know, soy divertida. Of course you can. And I will explain later on. But when you want to express your current mood, you need to use estar. Okay, again, it's how you feel at the moment, okay, or how you feel, not at the moment, literally right now, maybe at this time of your life, okay, maybe at this period of your life, estoy aburrida, estoy cansada, estoy estresada, okay. Now, we finish with the first part of ser and estar regarding, you know, the basic, the most clear, the most basic differences between ser and estar. We're gonna go to the second part. It's actually not too long, not too much, sorry. But we're gonna explain now about sometimes the ambiguities that can appear regarding ser and estar. Okay, we're gonna start first with ser. But with ser, I'm gonna explain one thing, for example. Now, this is the second part. When we want to explain something like un evento, okay? Like an event. O un acontecimiento, an event, okay? We want to say where is gonna be the event, we can use verbo ser. For example, how can I say? Mi vuelo, okay? Mi vuelo, my flight, okay? Es por la mañana. Some people sometimes there, it can be confusing, like, but it's no kind of location, Maria, because you already say star location, no, because and estar is about location. And this time, I'm talking about an event. Mi vuelo es por la mañana. Mis clases de español son en la escuela. Son en línea. Okay? So, I'm talking about events. El matrimonio de mi amiga es el sábado. Okay, so I'm talking about events. I'm not talking about places. I'm not talking about location. I'm not talking about the airport, about the church. You know where it's going to be the wedding. I'm talking about events. Okay, so do not confuse with event and where the place is, when it's going to be the event. And, okay, sometimes this can be a bit confusing for some people when they learn in ser and estar. Another one, and actually I love this one because it's so many memes and like jokes all the time in Spanish about this confusion between a set and a start. Like for example, what is the difference between soy aburrida or estoy aburrida? Both of them are correct. What is different is what I'm saying. Okay, if I say soy aburrida, I'm telling you that I'm a boring person. That's fine. I could be. Maybe I am. But I'm telling you about my personality. I am boring. Maria es aburrida. Okay? Actually, the reason my English is so bad, I keep blaming my poor English teacher when I was in school, but ella era, okay, I'm talking about past tense, of course, because, but muy aburrida, Dios mío. Okay, la profesora es muy aburrida. Okay, but you describe it in general, she's boring. Okay, and one thing is to say estoy aburrida. When I say estoy aburrida, I mean I'm bored. I'm bored. I'm bored of this video. I hope not. I'm bored of this video. I'm bored of this class. I'm bored of this job. You know, I'm bored of the summer. No, I don't think so. But okay, you know what I mean. Soy aburrida, you're talking about a quality, a permanent quality, like you are boring, or that person is boring as a person. Estoy aburrida, you're talking about, again, we go back to mood, okay? Like the situation, yeah, I'm bored, right now I'm bored, estoy aburrida, okay? Or, por ejemplo, another one that sometimes can be confusion, it's actually funny confusion, like, one thing is like, ¿es bueno o está bueno? Okay, bueno, as you probably know, is it means good. Okay, so when you say, well, in my case, I'm gonna say, el chico, okay, o el joven, o el muchacho, el hombre, I don't know, use the word you like it more, okay, I'm gonna say, el chico, you know, es muy bueno, okay? O, por ejemplo, mi amigo es bueno. Well, I mean, he's a good person, he's nice, you know, he's kind. But if I say, mi amigo está bueno, it's different. I mean, my friend is hot. O el chico está bueno. You know, the guy is hot. O la chica está buena. She's hot. She's good looking. Ella es buena. Mi amiga es buena. She's a good person. Again, for this part, that's why I put it as a second part, it's not that probably it's going to be like, oh, these rules, is gonna you're going to find it in Google or in a book. But it's in our natural way to speak everywhere. Not just in Spain, not just in Latin America, everywhere. This part about es bueno, está bueno, soy aburrida, estoy aburrida. Okay? And the last one will be with enfermo. What I'm saying with enfermo? Enfermo, okay, is mean to be sick, okay? But when, for example, if I have a cold, okay? If I have a cold, if I have the flu or whatever, I can say, uy, estoy enferma, estoy con fiebre, estoy enferma hoy. Okay, it's current, okay? It's not permanent, it's a temporary state, so estoy enferma. But when you say soy enfermo, it's possible to say that, yes, but not in that context. For example, if you have like a chronic illness, okay, por ejemplo, soy enferma de diabetes, soy enferma de lupus, okay, so when you mean as a general illness, when you mean, basically mean as a chronic illness that belongs to you as a permanent characteristic, yes, you're gonna use sir, but when you just want to express, then you're just feeling sick, I don't know, estoy enferma de no sé, insolación, you know, sunburning, no? Something like sun rash, okay, that's different, okay. I hope that this video is been helpful for you. Tell me if you would like me to do a second part of Serie Star. It's a lot really to cover on Serie Star. I have another video on the channel when sometimes I do differences, small differences about, but in the past tense. But this is the first video actually I do like very general on Serie Star. Again, I really hope that this was helpful for you. Let me know in the comments what you think about the video. What you think about the content of the channel, okay? If you haven't subscribed to the channel until this point, you know, subscribe button. And I do hope to see you again in our next videos. Ciao, ciao. Adios.